Tulpa, is you, your own mind, just fucked with so it appears to the part you consider yourself as a separate entity. They are literally just thought forms. Tulpa can't really possess you unless you are really that fucked up in the head. A Tulpa is a reflection of their host in a lot of ways, which is why I agree on the idea of being in the right mindset when making one. Just like being a parent or a pet owner, of course doing one with a weak one or not proper feelings is going to blow eventually. But as any person, they can develop over time with proper care. A lot still depends on your end, as you are the one in charge. A lot of people seem to forget that the Tulpa relies entirely on your attention to survive, so they adapt to your meet certain needs. Mind over matter and the power of belief can do some impressive things. Sometimes mind can make the matter. This only happens if you're a pussy. Treat your thought forms with respect, but you have to be dominant too, like you would treat any pet. And don't make one if you're fucked up in the head, it'll make them fucked up too. And it's not advised to let them have more power than you, because if they decide to rebel against you, then how are you supposed to stop them if they're the stronger one? Just keep trying if you can make her right away. Some people from their Tulpas much quicker than others. They are definitely great companions and can fill your life with a genuine joy that real people could never give. I support you, lad.
If you seek an audience with His Grace, you must open this door. I hold the key, and I will die defending it.
There was lots of potential gas sites in the Siberian region far up north, and I used to go around potential sites with company borehole engineers. It was faint, just on the border of hearing. I never knew how to describe those noises until a few years later when someone took me out to a jazz bar and some guy was playing a violin-like instrument that made this round noise like a Here's a nice short one for you. Are you ready? Black holes are stars whose outwardly repulsive forces are overcome by the inward tug of gravity as they expend all their fuel. They have mass and they have density. They are hidden behind the event horizon because they create an event horizon, a point from which closer light is unable to escape. Something infinitesimally small is there, but with an obscenely large amount of mass. What it is we don't know, because it can be seen. We may never know. Flat Earth, just look at the dimension this topic descends into. There is so much hysteria in people, which is a public demonstration of entity infection. The dweller of the abyss himself, the lord of chaos, cancer, and cholera. I am convinced that once someone is dissuaded from logical, scientific models that have been accepted for thousands of years, there is no going back. People who believe in a flat earth are absolutely ridiculous and absurd. Short of finding your own space program, or waiting for some volunteer position to open up and praying to God, Vishnu, Thor, and Isis that you win the raffle, all you have is the preponderance of evidence. It's not technically scientific, but it's the best we have. You might disagree, but based on what we see, it will take a whole new layer of reality for Earth being flat to be true. Half the time you ignore segments of footage from various live feeds that independent observers have captured on record. We see intelligently operated craft consistent with sightings and footage from the ground. We see the majority of it happening over a spherical Earth of a fisheye lens. It's round. There's no proof to the contrary.